So is that some kind of a contra view that you're taking on India? Because overall you mentioned that you're far more optimistic on the US. So is valuations the only reason why you're looking at India right now?
I think it's valuations and growth. And just to clarify in terms of the view on India, it's within the Asia ex-Japan context. So US would be our preferred market, developed markets would be our preferred region, and then within Asia we like Hong Kong and India. Those would be the two preferred markets within Asia. Why do we like India? It's on the back of valuations. The market is not particularly expensive at this point in time, actually quite attractive relative to its own history, quite attractive also against the ASEAN market as well, and earnings growth is expected to come in reasonably strong at around 10%, which is still pretty good compared to most other markets. The other key drivers for the Indian market is the expectation that politics are slowly moving in the right direction. There's been a lot of talk in terms of increasing foreign direct investment, which is obviously positive, and opening up the local economy to foreign investors and foreign corporates, and that's obviously very positive for Indian markets as well as the underlying economy. So those are three reasons why we like the Indian market at this point.
What about some of the longer term issues that we keep hearing of again and again? Are twin deficits on the fiscal side, on the current account side, the fact that the investment cycle doesn't seem to be really moving, at least as quickly as one would have imagined?
No, I mean, those are two issues that one has to focus on, and the current account deficit is an issue, or the deficit in terms of trade, that's an issue, and obviously, we are focused on that. I think the key thing for us, though, is we need to look at equities as an asset class, and we look at equities across the entire spectrum of corporates across Asia, and when you look at India, it does look like one of the more attractive markets, including the view that we have, obviously, on the infrastructure investment and also on the current account.